Hello, and welcome to What Never Was. This came out in 2019, and I'm not sure if it's a first chapter or a demo of a longer game they plan on making, so let's jump into it, shall we?
Hey, Mom, where are you? Wait, what? So you're not coming? But I'm already here. I know, but Mom, don't we owe it to Grandpa to... Yeah, I know. It's just... What? You can't sell the clock? Grandpa's had that for years.
Okay, whatever. It's fine. I can just start clearing out my boxes and then... I don't know. We can come back tomorrow and do the rest? Yeah, bye.
I'm really going to miss you, Grandpa. All right, let's do this.
Okay, so I'm running on the assumption that our granddad has died and we're clearing out his house. Can we go back downstairs? We could crouch.
It's the hatch I came up through.
Okay. Some objects are worth inspecting more than once.
Oh, Grandma's cello. So this is where it ended up. Oh. Grandma's cello.
Not that one, apparently.
So this is where
it
ended up.
That's not worth investigating twice. What is...
It's going to take forever to sort through all these. Grandpa sure did like his books.
Okay, right. Interact. Can I...
I should stay and at least get my stuff.
Damn it. Okay, I'll stop trying to leave.
I really wish I knew if that was in tune or not.
No, I don't think it is. I might be wrong, but I don't think it's meant to sound like that.
Nah, I don't feel like reading up on kings, countries, or history right now.
Okay. Ooh, magnifying glass.
It's a magnifying glass. For magnifying things.
You don't say. Squeak. Okay.
Aww. It's a picture of us. Grandpa. You sweet old bastard.
Oh, he seems nice.
It's Grandpa on one of his expeditions. He sure was adventurous. This must be from Grandma and Grandpa's wedding. I'm only here to pick up my stuff, but maybe I'll grab this later.
Cute. Okay, could we interact with any of the maps?
Oh, Grandpa's old travel diary. Seems like a few pages are missing.
Ah, so
I should see if I can find the missing pages before moving this.
Okay. Are they in here?
A desk drawer. It's locked. 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 It's locked.
Okay.
A desk drawer.
This one is not locked. Haha.
An open desk drawer.
No shit. Okay.
A desk drawer.
So she won't let us take anything out of that drawer.
Ah, the old gramophone. Yeah. Enough of that. This looks like one of the diary pages.
Okay. Tab. It seems no coincidence that both the resting place of Pele and... I'm not able to pronounce that, I'm sorry. Would happen to be in mountains. The trek has gone well, and though the winds are ominous, my clothing and necessities have carried me well so far. The guide I hired upon arrival have provided invaluable, not only in his knowledge of the thick forest, but also for his rich knowledge and company. Not unexpectedly, this symbol of water could be found at the peak of the summit, along with the alchemical symbol of water. Again, these symbols seem interconnected, and when one set are alchemic symbols known to many people, the others seem strange, of no cultural design that at least I am knowledgeable of. The encounter on Hawaii makes me certain that the other two elements must bear significance as well. What will I find on this mountain? Oh, we have our own stuff. Matt's in flip phone, a year old but still works pretty great. I'm not in a hurry to upgrade, even though the new smartphones still look pretty nifty. Maybe I could if I could afford one. Aw, I like the little sticker. Can we use this? Oh, we can turn it. Thursday, August 20th. Okay, that doesn't tell us a year or anything. Student ID. A student ID from my school. I'm still not quite sure if studying botanics and biology is right for me. And God knows Mum doesn't think so. But I like nature, and I like the idea of maybe one day fixing the planet and winning the Nobel Prize or something. Or setting up a flower shop. You know, whichever. Also not the best picture, but yeah, that's me. I like her, she looks cool. Kinda reminds me of, the non-blue-haired girl from Life is Strange, that one. A necklace I got from Grandpa when I turned 10. He joked that it was magical and it would keep me safe from monsters and such under my bed, and I believed him for the longest time. I've wore it since, and now that he's gone, I don't think I'll ever stop wearing it. What is this? Play me.
A tape recorder.
Hello. This is Howard James Wright with a message for my granddaughter, Sarah Elizabeth Wright. So if anyone else is listening, they can start off immediately, please.
I knew I liked this guy.
Sarah, if you are listening to this, then it means... Well, it means I'm gone. But I don't want you to be too sad about it. That's just the way life goes sometimes. So, chin up, my little pixie. Remember our grand moments. All the adventures we had when you were a little one and I wasn't such a cranky old man. I know you have questions for me. It's true I kept secrets from you and your mother. But there were good reasons. There are things in this world greater than ourselves, and I needed to protect you from them. I didn't want either of you to face the dangers that I've had to... I never wanted to place such a burden on your shoulders, but now it's unavoidable. Pixie, I need your help, but I can't just tell you. I have to show you. You will need to see for yourself. This world is full of secrets. From the tallest tree to the deepest river, in every breath of wind and every dancing flame, all you have to do is look. Goodbye, Sarah. I love you very much.
Goodbye, Grandpa.
Okay. That was really sweet. I like that a lot. Pig.
Hey, Mr. Piggles. How have you been holding up?
Okay, I'll stop tormenting the pig.
Calm
I'm sorry.
Down. My old A-station.
A-station.
I spent hours playing games on this thing. Damn, the adapter's missing. Probably for the best. I wouldn't get anything done today if I started playing.
Yeah, I know that feeling. Oops.
Celtic myths and legends.
Okay, so... My granddad actually was like a proper history enthusiast. It's not just a thing that he was looking into.
It's going to take forever to sort through all these.
Like, this must have taken years to actually amass a collection like this.
The hero with a thousand faces. Whoa. This looks like it belongs in a museum. Or like a Scottish cathedral. Whoa. Nuh-uh. I've watched too many movies to go about stealing ancient relics.
Oh, come on. Take it.
I prefer my face unmelted. Thank you very much.
Take it.
Nuh-uh. I've watched too many movies. Celtic myths
and legends.
A torn out page.
Got another page? Journal page. Oh no, it's journal page one we got. Okay. I finally landed on Hawaii and will soon begin my arduous climb of Mauna Loa. I'm not much of a climber, but I am filled with determination. Is that an Undertale reference? I will, however, first take some days to recuperate from the very tiresome travel, from which my fear of flights did not exactly improve. Not only was the pilot rude and dismissive of safety protocol, he also seemed completely unsure at times of what he was doing. That is not good. Regardless, I'm here and will spend the coming days in the village of Hala. Whatever secrets Pele, Goddess of Fire, holds, it is now within my grasp. I have definitely reached the right place. Although I am weary from travel, I am too excited to sleep. The villagers are friendly, but warn me of hurting customs, something I have no intent to do. I have also noticed the alchemic symbol of fire etched over people's doorways. It connects to Pele, of course, but is it linked to the crest I've sought as well? Okay. So Grandpa actually did, like, wander the world looking for stuff. He wasn't just, like, an armchair explorer. Wait, what's this? Come on, that looks cool. Let me see it. Okay, I don't think we can interact with that. Damn it. Okay. Ooh, key.
It's a small, simple key. Maybe it fits the desk.
Just my thought. Take it. Small key. Is there anything? No, there's nothing in there we can take or mess with.
These books are all so old.
Nope.
Hey,
okay,
wait.
That's nothing new.
Is that the biography of George Lucas?
Fusang, China.
Does this globe have anything to do with Grandpa's message? What did the message say again? The world is full of secrets, from the tallest tree to the deepest river.
Ah.
In every breath of wind and every dancing flame.
Earth, water, air, fire.
Could he be referring to these symbols? Does this globe have anything to do with Grandpa's message?
Okay, so earth?
He's saying oh, okay. These can be pushed.
Water. Oh, no, that wasn't water. Okay. Earth? Ah, that's fire, yeah. Water. Air. Fire.
I did it!
What's in it?
This looks like... Is this a second part of my necklace?
Ooh.
This looks like... Is this a second part of my necklace?
Magical shit?
Whoa!
Magical shit! That's cool. I want that as a necklace. Maybe I should try and make something like that with clay. Oh, is this like the stone from Coraline?
Whoa.
It is!
Seriously.
Ah, it's so cool. Oh, there's something in the desk? Okay, we'll have a look at the desk in a second, because we did just get the key. Oh, the clock as well. It was... Earth?
My grandfather's grandfather clock. How much wood would a woodchuck chuck if a... The key I have doesn't...
No, I'm not trying
Grandpa
the key.
Grandpa
loved okay,
this thing.
It's got a thing
told
on it, I guess.
Told me it was one of a kind. Although, he never actually told me why. An open desk drawer.
Oh, shush. Let me close it.
A desk drawer.
Nothing. Nothing. Ooh.
What's this?
Journal page. Journal page 3. The alchemic symbol of earth combined with the Chinese one for tree. While a trip has yet again gone well, and my research has once again led me to these symbols, I can draw no conclusion. I've spent most of my life researching these mythological connections, yet again I reach my destination, and nothing. Almost as if this is all an extremely elaborate prank. I sometimes wonder if my daughter is right. Months, nay, years of planning, only to eventually find a temple or shrine with another symbol, another riddle, and another clue. However, at the same time, it feels like I'm so close to finding some- Okay, got cut off, that's worrying.
An open desk drawer.
Yeah, I'm in. Look at the things. Ooh.
Huh. This tin box looks fairly old, and has a combination lock on it.
Okay, so... I'm assuming we'll find the password for that somewhere in the room. Empty... Ooh,
it looks
page.
Like a torn out page.
And a picture.
What's this?
Journal photograph. An old photograph found in Grandpa's desk. It says Sultan Hassan Mosque Madrasa, Egypt, 1966. Must have been from one of his trips. Okay, so he's ended up in Egypt as well. Nice. Journal page 4. all that I've worked for. It's here, I know it. The necklace in the temple in China made all the difference, and now I'm finally in Africa, hoping to set the burning sensation of curiosity to peace. The symbols line up, and my calculations were correct. The anonymous mail I received helped on a grand scale, but I still have not managed to figure out the sender. Regardless, the last piece of knowledge should be here, in Egypt, and after having evaded my guide, I have now found the symbols. It's time. Time to learn what is behind these strange connections and events. What events?
An open desk drawer.
Oh, come on, let me look at all the cool stuff.
Nah.
An open desk drawer.
We didn't find anything particularly interesting except for like the box and the pages, so... Wait, can I-
A desk drawer.
Ah, I can unlock these too. Journal page. Nothing. Journal page, Elphston. Elphston, also sometimes known as Trollstones. The subject of Scandinavian folklore, normal rocks with holes in them the size of an acorn were considered lucky, otherworldly, and useful. Hung from the necks of livestock, it would protect them, and their farmers alike, from malicious predators, trolls, and even incubi. In some tales, the owner of a true Elphston is also able to see the otherwise invisible common troll through the hole of the rock. Is there a troll in this room? While several of these were on display, only one of them looked to be the one I was looking for, carved in a way that no average jeweler could, and with ore in place of where the hole should be. I didn't acquire it through the most honest of means, but no one came to harm, and I'm sure its disappearance won't be noticed. I do wonder how it fits into all of this, though. I must study it thoroughly. Okay. Yeah, have we got everything from this desk? Except for the box. I believe so.
I have always loved the British countryside.
It's far too sunny for it to be Britain. Jesus Christ. What is that is the most stretched house I've ever seen. What's around this way? A break in the skybox. That's fine. Can I not interact with the British countryside? No. Alright, fair enough. I wouldn't want to either. Looks like whales out there. Ugh. Okay, so now what? We've got the stone. The stone wants us to interact with the clock, but I'm not sure what to do with the clock. Hold up. I think I just figured it out. Elphston might be usable on the box. Nope. One too long. No, too long. What's our surname? Maybe that's the thing. Right, that won't work. Okay.
Fairies by Brian Froud and Alan Lee.
Froud and Leon, right.
These books are all so old. The Hero with a Thousand Faces.
Campbell's Too
by
Long.
Joseph Campbell. I don't think I'm getting any more out of this globe.
Okay, the crucifix doesn't light up like I thought it would. Okay. Anything around here? Because I still need a key to get into the clock face. At least I think I do.
Come to think of it, I don't even know where he got it from. On one of his travels, I guess. The key I have doesn't fit here.
I'm gonna assume the key is in that lockbox. Is our name the lockbox thing? The code? S-A-R-A-H, maybe? A-R... I think it is our name. A-H.
Okay, Gramp, damn. I was sure that would be it.
Oh.
Maybe I need something else to solve this. This tin box looks fairly old, and has a combination lock on it.
I thought that would be it. Okay.
Okay, Grandpa. I need a clue to unlock this box. So if you're here...
Wait.
Guess I'll have to work it out myself. What could the combination be?
Ah, alright. So they have like a... X on them if they're correct. Grandpa was clever and had a lot of spare time, it seems. I'd love to set up something like this, though. Ah, it's Pixie. Okay, it doesn't spell anything interesting.
Whoa, fancy key.
Okay, let's listen to it. Well, that's ominous.
Okay.
Aren't these triangles in the journal pages?
They were, but I'm not sure what to do with... Nope, don't close it.
I'd take it if I could. But where in my 18 square meter student apartment would I fit this thing?
You'll find somewhere. But you can't let this be sold. This is gorgeous.
My grandfather's grandfather clock. Grandpa loved this thing. Told me it was one of a kind. Come to think of it, I don't even know where he got it from. I can't believe Mom wants to sell this. I get that he missed a lot of her childhood. But come on.
Grandpa loved reading maps. And making maps. I wonder how many of these he charted or drew himself. I loved when we drew maps of places we made up together. We draw our own cities, fantasy villages and the like. All names something along the lines of Sarahville, of course. But hey, what do you expect from an 8-year-old girl?
Wait, is there something I can do with the clock notes? Oh, I am stupid. I'm so stupid. Ignore me. Okay. Stone is the cure to all problems, so earth goes directly down.
It won't budge.
Ah, I just went past it. Earth goes directly down.
It's stuck in place.
Fire goes at 11.
This button seems to select clock hands.
I think that's fire. Water goes at 8. Which one's water? Water is downwards triangle.
I probably need to select the clock hand somehow.
And then air goes at 2.
Was that it? Did I do it?
Yes.
Whoa. What's happening? No.
That was the first time I traveled by magic, pulling at the thread that would unravel my grandfather's mysteries. I so wish he told me sooner, so we could have gone on at least one adventure together. Instead, I went on his adventure, the one that never was. But that is a longer story, for another time.
I thoroughly enjoyed that. I really hope we get an actual proper... bigger game from this soon, because this came out in 2019, and it's now 2023. I really, really hope we get a bigger game, because this was very interesting. Like, I really like a lot of the old mythology sort of thing. I really like the way this was paced as well. This had rather simple puzzles, but because I'm a dumbass, it took me a little while for a couple of them, but yeah, that was really, really fun. Thank you very much, and I will see you in a different video.